Hi, have you ever wondered what are the main differences between G0 and G01? I'm Alexander Siasas, and today we're going to learn how can we optimally use each one so as to be more productive. Without further ado, let's discuss about the differences between G0 and G01. First of all, both of them are modal and they belong to the same group, the first group. This means that they stay active until another command from the same group cancels them, and also because they belong to the same group, G0 cancels G1, and vice versa. It has to be noted that G2 and G3 also belong to the first group. The main difference between these two commands is that when we program G0, we cannot program feed rate of the axis. And when we program G1, we can program the feed rate of the axis. The only way to control the feed rate of the axis when we have programmed G0 is by using the relative knob or buttons on the orchodronal panel. G0 refers to the rapid movement of the axis, and G1 refers to the linear interpolation of the axis. This means that when we program G0, the resulted movement is not so intuitive. On the other hand, when we program G1, the resulted movement is usually a line. So the result of programming G1 is more intuitive than when we program G0. Okay, so now let's see an example. Let's say that we have to go from point 1 to point 2. When we program this movement by using G0, the result is not a straight line. This is why when we program G0, we actually command the machine tool to drive its axis to the maximum feed rate. So this movement can be analyzed as follows. When the command is executed, both axes will accelerate to their maximum feed rate, and when, for example, in this example, the y-axis finds its final position, will stop, and then x-axis will go on until it finds its final position. On the other hand, when we program the same movement by using G1, the final result is a linear motion. This is why when we program G1, we actually control both axes to start accelerating at the same time, to get their final speed at the same time, go on as long as this movement goes. Then it stops at the same time and starts decelerating at the same time. Anytime adding these two feed rates will give us the actual feed rate, as you can see here. Okay, so this shows us that we cannot rely on G0 when we want to do a precise movement, because we cannot imagine, if you want, the final movement. Thus, given that the result of the movement when we program G0 is actually not very intuitive, not very predictable, the best way to program a machining task is to define a safe Z level. For example, my personal choice is 10 millimeters. For every movement that is above 10 millimeters, I can use safely G0. Whenever I go below 10 millimeters, I start considering programming G01. The only exception is, for example, when we drill something or when we are in a pocket, or generally when we want to retract along z-axis. When we want to retract along z-axis, we can safely use G0. Finally, I've got a bonus tip for you if you want to be more productive, to lower your machining times even more, and this is that you can use G0 below safe Z level, but be careful to use it only to program straight lines, because as we saw before, whenever you want to go from point 1 to point 2, the final movement will be something that is not very intuitive. So if you break this line, this movement, into two different straight lines, it will be better for us programmers to understand, and it will be more safe. Okay, that's it for today. If you have any comments, any questions, any suggestions, please comment below. If you liked this video, give us a thumbs up. If you liked it and you want to see more, please subscribe. And if you want to help our channel grow, please share to other social media platforms. So bye for now and see you next time.